The Meteorological Service of Jamaica has extended the flash flood warning across all parishes in Jamaica, as several roads remain impassable as a result of landslides and heavy flood waters. The Meteorological Service of Jamaica has extended the flash flood warning for all low-lying and flood-prone areas in all parishes until 5 p.m. on Monday. This is as a result of heavy rains, thunderstorms, and gusty winds that continue to cause flooding and landslides in various communities across several parishes in Jamaica. The Meteorological Service has stated that the outer bands of Tropical Storm Zeta are intensifying the levels of rainfall across Jamaica. The storm is not a direct threat to Jamaica, and it is forecast to move away from the country over the next few days as the week progresses. However, as it stands, several roads in Kingston were flooded on Sunday afternoon, and as a result, there were several other roads in the corporate area and other parishes that remain impassable due to flood waters, landslides, and debris. The National Works Agency has stated that the Bogwalk Gorge in St. Catherine is currently closed as the Rio Cobre is in spate. Motorists have been urged to use Sligo Vale or the North-South Highway. The NWA also reported that in Clarendon, the Alley Bridge, Maypen to Source Upturn in New Longsville, Tollgate and Four Paths are also flooded and blocked. The Rock River to Ginger Hill Road in the parish was also affected by land slippages and fallen rocks, as well as the Mucko to Frankfield Corridor. Colonel's Ridge to Kellys in northern Clarendon is also impassable at this time. Manchester, the Manchester Road and the Carteret Road are flooded, while in St. Elizabeth, flooding was reported in Junction to Lacovia to Mountainside and Lacovia to Newton Roads, as well as in Nain and Ginger Hill. The Holland Bamboo Main Road in St. Elizabeth was also blocked by fallen bamboos. The main road leading from Sheffield to Negril in Westmorland was also flooded. The roads bordering Westmorland and Hanover were reduced to single-lane traffic on Sunday due to fallen trees. The road from Anchovy to Shettlewood in St. James was also reduced to single-lane traffic. There were also reports of flooding in Bath, St. Thomas, and landslides in the vicinity of Morant River Bridge. According to the NWA, they are warning motorists to drive very carefully on these roads. They have also issued a warning to motorists driving small vehicles not to traverse the roadway from Seaforth to Trinityville, as the river in that vicinity is in spate. Papin to Bull Bay in St. Andrew remains blocked by debris caused by landslides, while there were reports of landslides in Craigale in rural St. Andrew. A man had to be removed from wreckage following a crash along Marcus Garvey Drive on Sunday. Firefighters had to remove a gentleman from a Toyota Probox motor car that crashed along Marcus Garvey Drive in Kingston on Sunday afternoon. Based on reports coming in, it appeared that the vehicle crashed into a utility pole near Petrodram. Eyewitnesses have stated that the driver, who was the only occupant of the car, was speeding. The man was later rushed to the hospital, and his condition remains unknown at this time. The police are currently investigating this matter. Flood waters should not be underestimated, and it should be noted that these waters can spread infectious diseases and that they may contain chemical hazards and may cause injuries to persons that may wade through these waters. Across the globe, every year, flooding causes a lot of fatalities, and it sometimes causes more fatalities than is related to thunderstorms. The most common fatalities occur when a vehicle that is driven into hazardous flood waters takes the lives of the occupants. There are steps that you can take to ensure that you are protected during a flood. You must first gather your emergency supplies. Listen to your radio or television station for updates on the flood. Ensure that you fill bathtubs, sinks, gallon jars, or plastic soda bottles so that you will have a supply of clean water. Ensure that you also sanitize your sinks and your tubs before cleaning them or using them for diluted household laundry. Also, ensure that they are very clean before using them to store water. You should clean them with bleach and then rinse and fill them with clean water. You should also ensure that anything that you store outdoors is returned inside. If you have lawn furniture, grills, trash cans, you should secure them firmly. If you need to evacuate, you should turn off all utilities at the main power switch and close the main gas valve. Evacuate areas that are subject to flooding. Stay away from low-lying areas, canons, or washes. Also, ensure that your immunization records and any other important documents are very close to you and that they are stored in waterproof containers. After the flood, ensure that you only consume clean, safe water. Do not drink flood water. Do not use it to wash dishes nor to brush your teeth, and especially do not use it to wash or prepare food. If you have evacuated your home, only return to your house after local authorities have given you that directive. Listen to advisories about water from local authorities to find out if your water is safe for drinking and bathing. During an advisory, use only bottled, boiled, or treated water for drinking and cooking. Avoid driving your vehicles through flooded areas and standing water. As little as 6 inches of water may cause you to lose control of your vehicle. Ensure that you use generators and pressure washers outside, at least 20 feet from any doors, windows, and vents. When you return home after evacuating your home, you should ensure that your home is not flooded. However, if it is flooded, only enter if it is safe to do so. Also, clean your house and sanitize your things. If you are in doubt and if something is extremely wet and dirty, throw it out. Remove and throw out all drywall and insulation that would have been contaminated with flood water or sewage waters. Do not use items that cannot be washed or cleaned with bleach. Do not reuse your mattresses, your pillows, your carpeting, or your carpet padding or stuffed toys. These may be extremely difficult to fully clean with bleach. Use undiluted laundry bleach to clean dirt and mold off items like floors, stoves, sinks, countertops, plates, and tools. Ensure that you remain safe during this hurricane season and be very cautious during flood rains and heavy flood waters that may be on the road. Be very careful about land slippages while you drive. And if your home is close to an area with soil that is saturated, be careful as well. Ensure that you practice all the necessary emergency or hurricane or flood preparedness tips that may be issued by your emergency agencies. Be safe. Remember to share the content. Like, comment, share, and subscribe. Let me know what you think about the roads that are currently blocked in Jamaica as a result of land slippages and heavy flood waters. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.